Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Sadhguru Pandit, and we are on Facebook Live at Nanavati Super Specialty Hospital. Today, we have been joined by Dr. Sushant Patil. Hello, Dr. Patil. Dr. Sushant Patil is an eminent cardiologist, and he's been with us for over many years. He has an experience of over 13 years. So, Dr. Patil will today talk about the cardiovascular diseases amidst the pandemic. And what are the challenges faced by cardiology patients or patients with heart problems during this pandemic? So, Dr. Patil, let's start with the most important question that we are facing today. That what do you think is the impact of the pandemic for cardiology patients?
Yeah. So, good afternoon, everyone. It's like, you know, we all know that we must be aware that COVID-19 has got a significant collateral impact on cardiovascular diseases. Like, you know, in patients who are in old age and they have diabetes, hypertension, obesity, and a previous ischemic heart disease, they are at a higher risk of having morbidities and mortality because of COVID infection. So COVID-19 infection, it predisposes for newer thrombosis, you know, venous thrombosis, you know, it causes acute coronary syndrome, and there are a lot of heart-related arrhythmias and direct effect on the heart muscle, causing low pumping of the heart and heart failure eventually. So it has got a significant impact on the cardiovascular diseases.
All right. We can understand, sir, that. Doctor already correctly mentioned that, you know, cardiology patients are one of the most affected patients and vulnerable patients in this pandemic. So what do you think are the most common symptoms or common issues of cardiology that you have come across?
So currently in the COVID-19 pandemic, because of the pandemic, we are facing issues as in, you know, patients presenting quite late because they are scared. They don't want to come to the hospital because they are afraid that they can, you know, get COVID infection. And that's the reason why they've been presenting late. And then they've been sitting on their symptoms for quite a few days, and then they present late with chest pain and a lot of arrhythmias. And there are issues with they're not been able to follow the medications, you know, they're not been able to continue with their routine lifestyle, which has been hampered because they've been in home and then isolated or quarantined. There's a lot of stress which is there. There is a lot of anxiety because of the disease. So these things play in the mind, and then, you know, that is the reason why we are seeing patients who are like severely ill, and then, you know, they present late to us. So it has got a significant impact on the cardiovascular disease per se.
Right. Also, you know, so what are the measures that as because we have been treating a lot of patients during the pandemic.
Right.
So what are the measures that we have put in place, doctor, that to ensure that our cardiology patients are safe and secure?
So we at Nanavati Hospital, we have taken enough, like, you know, we have followed a safe treatment pathway kind of a thing, you know, for such patients, so that, you know, we can concentrate equally on the non-COVID patients as compared to the COVID patients, because it is important that we should not neglect the non-COVID patients during the pandemic. So we have a safe treatment pathway, as in we have a different accident and emergency as compared to those for the COVID. So we have non-COVID patients going to a different accident emergency. We have a proper triage wherein the patients are segregated according to their symptoms. And then, you know, once they follow up in our OPDs are like green OPDs. And then once we have formulated, we have infrastructure which we have changed, as in we have a different setup and building for the COVID, and we have a different building for the non-COVID patients. And then we take enough precautions, as in those patients are not exposed to the COVID infection or the ones who have COVID. And following the treatment, as in if we have a patient of heart attack, then they straight away go to the green A&E. And then if we don't suspect COVID infection in them, then, you know, they are treated like a standard cardiac patient, like a heart attack patient. And then we immediately take them for interventions and then do the needful. So we are able to manage the emergency patients as well as the OPD elective patients equally because of this safe treatment pathways which we have made.
Right. So as you correctly mentioned, then it means that the patient from its entry to his exit in the hospital is completely safe. It's
completely safe.
Yeah, it's a safety net around him. for a non-COVID patient.
Right.
And that's a great thing.
Right.
But doctor, as you mentioned earlier, that a lot of patients are avoiding despite all these measures going to the hospital. What do you think can be the impact of that?
Yeah. So, you know what, I always, I would like to tell one thing that, you know, please don't neglect your symptoms and be scared about COVID infection and then, you know, avoid seeking medical help in those times, you know. Because if you present late, then it's difficult for managing such patients. So if you feel that, you know, you have some symptoms or you have a heart disease and you have blood pressure, diabetes, see to it that you are regularly taking your medications, you know, you're following your following a healthy diet and, you know, you're continuing with your lifestyle and exercise, meditation to avoid stress, and keep excess stock of the medication so that you don't run out of the supply. And then, you know, in case of any symptoms, you know, seek medical attention as early as possible so we are able to manage those things in time.
Right, right, doctor. So our viewers are posting a lot of questions. We'll take some of them now.
Yeah.
Our viewer Ayonija Das is asking, is there any specific advice to heart patients during the pandemic?
Yeah, so like I said, a heart patient in general, if he or she has got hypertension, diabetes, obese, you know, don't neglect the usual healthy lifestyle. You know, always follow a healthy lifestyle, considering your diet, follow an exercise protocol, which would be at least 150 minutes in a week or so, at least 150 minutes in a week. And, you know, be loyal to your medications, get your routine test done at time, seek your routine cardiac follow-up whenever it was due for. Don't be scared about, you know, COVID, because we all tertiary care centers have taken enough precautions for a safe treatment of non-COVID patients as well. And most important thing is maintain an excess supply or a stock of the medication so that, you know, you don't run out of them.
Correct, correct. Thanks a lot, doctor. So Shimona, one of our other viewers is asking, is COVID-19 patient who has a, if COVID-19 patient has a heart attack, is he treated any differently than a non-COVID patient?
Well, a COVID-19 patient who has a heart attack, first and foremost, we go ahead with the clot buster medication. First and foremost, we keep them in an area which is for a suspect or a confirmed COVID, which is our red accident and emergency. And then we start the treatment for the heart disease, okay, or the heart attack rather. We give them a clot buster medications, and then if the ECG improves, then we continue treating the patient on the medical treatment, keeping him in a COVID area. And once they are, you know, good enough to be discharged, then we call them back in the OPD and do the further interventions. Well, if such patients, if they don't improve after giving clot buster medications, then with all due precautions, we take them for the intervention and we finish and we do the needful what is required. So in other words, even if a COVID patient has a myocardial infarction or a heart attack, and he or she, if they require emergency intervention, as in an emergency angioplasty, it should be done, and it is usually done, taking all due precautions.
Correct, correct. So in shorter words, there is no other any different modality of treatment for them. It's just that an additional precaution.
It's just precautions which we take so that we don't expose him for any further infections,
right,
and other patients for COVID. But it's not that the interventions are not done in these patients. We
correct.
Do interventions
correct.
In these patients, but if they are required.
Correct, correct. Thanks a lot, doctor.
Yeah.
So Shimona also has another question. She wants to know if there are any other causes of heart attack besides blockage.
Yeah, so COVID-19 specifically, it increases the incidence of formation of clots in your body. Now that clot can be in your leg veins, it can be in your pulmonary arteries, or it can be in the arteries supplying blood to your heart as well, causing something which we call it as acute coronary syndrome. Many a times when we do angiography on these patients, especially young patients, we don't find significant blockages, although the clot which was there, it usually effectively get dissolved on giving the treatment. So it does increases the incidence of formation of clots in the coronary arteries. And the incidence is higher in older age group and patients who have other comorbidities like hypertension, diabetes, and obesity.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, doctor. Namita Das, one of our other viewers, was asking, from what age should one consider attending a heart screening for a regular heart health checkup?
So once you reach 40, I think we should start doing 35 to 40. We should start getting our routine investigations done. Although if you have symptoms, then obviously whenever you have symptoms, you should reach and seek medical help. And routine investigations, which involves a treadmill test and a 2D echo and other markers of heart disease like cholesterol, lipid profile. So that should be done irrespective of the pandemic. It's not related to the pandemic. The age is not defined for pandemic.
Correct, correct. Also, doctor, have you noticed that, a question related to this, that the problems of cardiac issues have started coming up in younger generation because that is one of the major issues that we are facing right now. And what do you think can be the causes of that?
Yeah, so considering the pandemic, the COVID-19 infection already predisposes you for formation of clots. On top of it, if the person has got some risk factors, as in a very strong family history, smoking and unhealthy lifestyle, sedentary lifestyle, having blood pressure, diabetes, or a chronic kidney problem predisposes them for formation of clots in the artery supplying blood to the heart. So they can land up with situations like heart attack or so. So young patients, secondly, I feel is the stress and anxiety about the disease itself, and not able to do your routine activities and exercise, not able to follow a healthy lifestyle. That also predisposes a lot of young patients for having heart attacks.
Right. So, Namita ji, as you had asked, this is an extension that people should actually start going for heart health checkups earlier now, as compared to the past when people were only going for it after once their 50s or 45, late 50s. It's better to start this by the age of 35 itself and start consulting with a renowned cardiologist regarding your everyday problems. Mercy Spark, one of our other viewers, is asking how to detect a heart attack and what are the warning signs of a heart attack?
Okay, so warning signs of heart attack would be like, feeling, getting chest pain, sweating, and severe tightness in your chest or pressure in your chest, and choking sensation, sometimes, many a times radiating to your left arm. These would be the warning signs for a heart attack in a patient. In fact, should be more alert in patients who have diabetes and hypertension. So these signs should not be neglected.
Correct, correct. Sir Gaurav Singh is asking, what is the role of diabetes in heart attack occurrence?
Well, diabetes, as we know, which increases the incidence of coronary artery disease in any patient, like it causes microvascular and microvascular disease, like coronary artery disease, be it chronic kidney disease, diabetes-related retinopathy. So diabetes increasing the risk of coronary artery disease, and in the COVID times, the risk is further increased in such patients by causing acute coronary syndromes and angina.
Right. So keeping the diabetes in check is always important for
Yes,
COVID. Yeah.
yes.
So Nitin Singh is asking, sir, what are the risk factors associated with getting a heart attack?
So this is unrelated to the current
Yeah.
pandemic, but the usual risk factors would be like, addictions as in smoking, and then having other cardiovascular disease like blood pressure, diabetes, a family history, overweight or obesity, unhealthy lifestyle, sedentary activity, no exercise, and these could be the risk factors for coronary artery disease.
Correct, correct. So apart from this, it's just an extension to this question. If you're following all the healthy parameters, as we call it, a good diet, a good exercise, but you're genetically predisposed to a heart condition,
Yes.
what should be your mantra to prevent any cardiac
You can't
problems?
do anything who is exposed genetically, as in family history can't be changed. We call them non-modifiable risk factors. Whatever
Okay.
you can modify, I think we should concentrate on that
Okay.
because that is the only thing which is there in our hands.
Okay. Thanks a lot, doctor. So Ranjita Yadav is asking, if heart disease runs in family, at what age should you be paying attention to the heart health, and what tests should I been doing? Should you be doing regularly?
Well, having a family history of heart disease is another non-modifiable risk factor. So there's no age limit, but such patients, such people can get heart disease early on in their lifespan. So whenever they get symptoms, then they should seek medical attention and then, you know, get their cholesterol checked and get checked for having blood pressure, get checked for having diabetes, and keep your weight in check. And there are other markers which we also do in patients who are high risk, like, you know, doing calcium scoring on a CT coronary angiography, doing a high sensitivity CRP level to find out how predisposed you are and what is your risk for developing a coronary artery disease. But there is no specific age, but there is a very high tendency that you might get it in an early age. So right. We need to be alert about that.
Right. And I would like to tell the viewers that hospitals such as ourselves have created certain packages or a certain bundle of tests which can accurately tell you what are the risk factors that you have and, you know, at what stage of the illness you are at. So you should always, these are routine tests which you can do, they come with a package. So you will get a bundle of tests together to give you a correct picture of your health standings.
Right.
Sir Terry Bhari, one of our viewers, is asking, why is that we see a lot of young people with heart attack nowadays, as we discussed earlier?
It's not nowadays, but since last few years, we've been seeing a trend as in a lot of young people, they get stroke and heart attack. I mean, again, unhealthy lifestyle, you know, not exercising, not doing routine examination, having a very strong family history, a stressful life, and most important thing would be the smoking. So we have seen the trend of young people getting heart attacks even before the pandemic. The pandemic is just added to the extra load. So timely checkup and keeping your weight and keeping your habits in check is the mantra for it.
Right. Dr. O'Neill Eric is asking, is chest pain normal after a heart attack?
Chest pain is not normal after a heart attack. Chest pain during a heart attack, and if you get chest pain after a heart attack, after you've been treated, then you should seek medical attention, and we should rule out any other cause other than the heart, whether that is the reason for your chest pain. Because ideally, you shouldn't have a chest pain after a heart attack and you've been treated adequately for the coronary artery disease or blockages which you have been found to.
Correct. So chest pain is not a symptom that you can ignore.
Yes.
Even after that.
Yes.
So, sir, Meghna Das is asking, how is heart attack different from a cardiac arrest?
So heart attack is a sequelae to less blood supply to the heart. Now, the reason for cardiac arrest could be many, and the less blood supply to the heart can be the reason for cardiac arrest, but it's not the same. So any abnormal rhythm of the heart, heart failure or blockages in your arteries, these are the reason you can land up with a cardiac arrest, or be it any other non-cardiovascular cause also can give rise to cardiac arrest. So cardiac arrest is the terminal event, which is the standstill of the heart, which happens because of n number of causes. So heart attack and cardiac arrest is not same.
Right. Which I think is a common misconception in many.
Yes.
Sir Anshika Singhal is asking, are patients with heart valve disease at more or less risk of getting infected with COVID-19?
No. They are not at higher risk of getting infected, but once they get infected, they have been seen to behave, or the morbidity is much more. They have a much severe disease if they get infected with COVID. But all age groups can get infected. Any age group can get infected with COVID-19. It's not that the patients who have heart or valve problem or diabetes or blood pressure are more prone for it. But if at all they contract COVID-19 infection, then they are at a higher risk or higher severity of the disease.
Right. Mr. Ranjit Yadav is asking the same question that we have answered in the past. Why are young people getting heart attacks?
So we have answered.
And there is one by Pawan Chavi who is asking how stress and sedentary lifestyle impact heart, which I think is also adequately answered.
Yes, because if you do a regular exercise, then you keep your blood pressure in control, you keep your sugars in control, you keep your weight in control, and you keep a check on your cholesterol as well. And these are the modifiable risk factors which you are taking care of when you don't have a sedentary lifestyle. So it has got a significant impact on cardiovascular disease.
Correct, sir. Correct. Also, you know, are there any symptoms that you would like to tell the viewers that, you know, a set of symptoms which cannot be ignored in terms of cardiovascular diseases? Sir?
Yeah. So if you experience shortness of breath, first of all, symptoms related to COVID-19 would be like fever or having cough, running nose, feeling tightness in your chest or feeling short of breath. You know, these symptoms should never be ignored. And in a patient in whom we are considering that he or she has got risk factors as in diabetes, blood pressure, or having a coronary artery disease, even in past, then these patients should be aware and not neglect the symptoms which are like, you know, chest pain, tightness in the chest, having sweating, you know, palpitations, shortness of breath. So these symptoms should never be neglected, and you should seek immediate medical attention for this and rule out cardiovascular disease.
Correct. And I hope all our viewers and the people connected to them get this message very quick and loud and clear that all the symptoms doctor mentioned are not to be ignored and avoided. So doctor, we talked about a lot of things. Can we also talk about the ways, because we are talking about the sedentary lifestyle, but also the life has become very busy for people who are staying in metros or metro cities and other busy areas. So what are the measures that they can take to avoid any cardiological problems in
So standard safe measures which have been laid by the governments, as in social distancing, and then, you know, wear a mask, avoid contact with your eyes, mouth and nose and face, and follow frequent hand washing the way they have mentioned. And then apart from that, the biggest problem is not being able to exercise and not being able to eat healthy because we are staying at home, and a significant impact on the psychology as well. And a lot of too much of stress and anxiety about the disease, being scared about COVID-19, not willing to go to the hospital if you have any symptoms, sitting on the symptoms for a while. So these things should be avoided, and follow a standard healthy lifestyle. Even if you are at home, go for stress relaxation, meditations, and then, you know, exercise at least whatever you can. In home, you can always modify and see to it that you exercise for at least 20-25 minutes. Take your medications regularly, keep an adequate stock of your medications, and then seek medical help in just in case if you have any symptoms. And you can always prefer online consultations and, you know, talk to someone and find out whether your symptoms are significant or whether your doctor wants you to see you personally in the hospital, and then, you know, get things done that way.
Correct. Thanks a lot, doctor. And 29th September, as we would like to inform everybody, is World Heart Day. We expect that all our viewers follow the instructions or the advice by Dr. Patil by 29th of September, which is a World Heart Day, and you start your journey to a healthier heart from this World Heart Day itself. So thanks a lot, doctor. Thank you for joining us and sharing very, very beautiful insights on the cardiovascular diseases. And I hope it was very beneficial for all our viewers who joined us today for the Facebook Live. Thanks a lot. Stay tuned for the next Facebook Live.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.